Hi crafters, it's Hannah, welcome to my channel today. This is the card that I'm going to be showing you how to make. So we're using the In This World stamp set along with some of the Memories and More cards. So I'm going to show you how I put this card together. Don't forget this stamp set is retiring, so you need to get it quickly before it is gone. And yeah, we will get started. Okay, so we're going to start off this card by stamping and colouring in the little chair from the In This World stamp set. And let's get that on my block. So I'm going to stamp it in Memento because I'm going to colour it in. Oh, it's gorgeous. I love this chair. I don't know why, but I absolutely love it. It's fab. Okay, so I'll zoom you in and focus. There we go. I'm going to colour them in using the Stampin' Blends. So I'll just do one, with you. And then I will do the other one. So I am going to be a little bit stereotypical and colour one in blue for a girl and one in pink for a girl and kind of blue for a boy, just because I want it to be kind of, it's going to be very obvious what the card is for, but you could obviously do different colours, whatever you wanted, but it's going to be like a couple cards I'm doing. So I'm going to do the legs of the chair with dark crumb cake, actually no, light crumb cake to start with. So just very quickly going over all of the legs, and then I'll go back in with the dark and highlight parts of it. So this card idea just sort of really randomly came to me. I was just looking through Pinterest for ideas, and then I didn't even know what I saw that just made me think, oh, this could be like the king and queen. So it made me think of a couple. So it could be a engagement or wedding or just or anniversary, so from a couple, from one couple, one person in the couple to the other, gosh, which is kind of, I think, what this one will end up looking like. So now you can't, you really can't see that very well. So I'm going to go back in with the dark just to add a little bit here and there, and kind of where it's already got the shadow in the image, I'm just going to add a little bit. And then for the chair part, I'm going, what colour is this? Pool party. So this is a light pool party, and I'm just going over the whole thing. And really saturate it well. I found that it blends better the more you saturate it. And this is a very light colour, so oh no, you can see it. I didn't know if it was showing up super well, but I think it is. So I'm just doing circular motions or just following the line. So you don't have to try and be neat particularly. I'm Okay, then just go back in with the dark one, and again wherever it's got shadow in the image, that's where I'm going to add a little bit more colour. So it's a good thing with these sort of images, it's already got the shading in there, so you don't have to think too much about where to add. You just follow what's on the image itself, which I find very useful. And then just go back over, make sure everything's blended nicely. The thing with them, I've found with these, it's kind of, or any alcohol marker, you kind of want to, you're making layers, so you go over and over and over until you've got a nice depth into the image. And then I'm just going to add, just on the buttons, a smidge of bronze. And on those ones here as well. So that's the first one, and then I'll do the other one, and then I'm going to fussy cut them out. So I'll do that and then come back. Okay, so I've got those both cut out, and we're going to put this card together really, really simply. I've got a doily. I've got one of the cards from the Bundle of Love Memories and More packs, and I've got a piece of the, what's it called? Love something, Bundle of Love Designer Series paper, which is gorgeous with the gold foiling, and then on the other side you've got a blue and you've got a pink option, but we're going to use the gold today. So it's going to sit on here. I'm only going to use half the doily, so some of it's just going to be popping out, and then we're going to have our two chairs like so. I've got a very vanilla card base, so I'm going to stick this down first. Oops. So pop that down. Just crease that a bit more. Right, there we go. Then half the doily sticking out. Now I think I might go a little bit skewiff, or should I go straight? Let me see. I might trim this down a little bit because I think I would like it better if it's kind of on a jaunty angle. So I'm literally going to just use the trimmer as a guide to how much to cut. So I'm just lining up the end of the card with that little line there, so you could go with this one or whichever one you want. I might go with that one actually. So I'm going to take that off on all four sides to make it even. Oops. There. So now we can go a little bit jaunty. Yeah, I like that better. And then half the doily, so I'll cut that in half. And we can use the other half on another card. So you could have the blue heart, but I'm going to go with the pink because I like pink. So just pop your doily on. Oh, and I've done it the wrong side. Oops. Needs to go that side. Like so. Then you can stick it down on a nice little jaunty angle. We'll go that way. Yeah, that looks cool. And then our chairs, we will pop up on dimensionals couple on the back of each one. One there. Stick it to my fingers. And then, where should we go? Okay, there. Oh, they're so cute. So I was gonna add some enamel shapes to it, but I'm not sure if I should. Maybe one heart in the middle, just over that. Or three hearts down the bottom. One there, or three down there. What do you think? I bet you're shouting out to me what to do. I'm gonna go with the three down the bottom. So let me know in the comments if you would have done it different. If you would have put the heart on there. Or whether you'd have just left them off completely. Let me know your thoughts. I think that's straight. That'll do. Oh, I like it very much. So that's our card for today. I hope that you have enjoyed it. And enjoyed watching. And I will see you next time. Bye.